Hello everyone, we are standing here today at the World Hydrogen Summit in Rotterdam. This event is organized by RX Global and we're at the stand of Elcogen, and I have the pleasure to speak with Hanna Granö-Fabritius from Elcogen. Welcome, Hanna.
Thank you very much.
I think I got your name right this time, right?
Almost.
Almost. Well, we'll have to do. Right, so Elcogen, I think quite a familiar name in the business, but I'm sure everybody is keen to hear a bit more. What is it that the business does and what is your role in it, please?
So Elcogen is a core supplier of solid oxide technology, which is basically a high temperature technology for fuel cells and also for electrolyte applications. This is where core technology supply, we supply basically the cell and the stack and also modules, but we do not fully vertically integrate. So you can't come to Elcogen and buy a system. What we do is we enable our customers to use our technology for their bespoke systems. So they basically then develop systems around our technology. The company is an Estonian-Finnish company. It was founded in Estonia in 2001, so it's been around for a while now. But we are in the centers of excellence both in Estonia and Finland. And right now we're also scaling our manufacturing capacity in Tallinn to commercially viable scale. So we are right now, we say, as a scale-up company.
Well, scaling is definitely something we need in the industry. So I'm glad that you guys are doing that. Can you tell us a little bit about sort of the factory and sort of the scaling process that you're currently going through?
Right now we have about 10 megawatts of capacity, but when the factory is up and running at full scale, we all actually have 360 megawatts of capacity. So that's also a commercially viable and commercially relevant capacity. The first phase is now going live at the end of this year. That will take us 90 megawatts, and then we will scale in phases as we go along. So we're now moving to basically automated manufacturing, and that will also help us to significantly reduce price, which is one of the challenges with the technology today.
Absolutely. Price is a big component upstream and also downstream. Maybe if I may ask about the technology and a choice on the fuel cell side, what is sort of like, in your own words, the advantages of using the solid oxide side as opposed to, for example, PEM or alkaline technology?
So for fuel cell applications, solid oxide is high temperature technology, so it's very, very efficient. Versus PEM, it also has the benefits that you can use different types of fuels. So we have biogas applications, we have natural gas applications. Obviously, you can also run on hydrogen. There's potential for ammonia in the future. We even have customers running on bioethanol. Whereas a PEM is a low temperature and you can run on very, very hydrogen alone and nothing else. Then on the other hand, the PEM has its place with mobility application, for instance, where solid oxide isn't a fit. Solid oxide more is for stationary applications and also has a lot of interest in the future for maritime applications as well.
So as I hear that, there's a lot of versatility in which the solid oxide fuel cell technology can be utilized. Versatility is also present in sort of the off-takers, or maybe not present, as a lot of the off-takers are currently not in the industry participating that much just yet, at least on the hydrogen front. What can you say about that?
Yeah, so we all know that green hydrogen offtake is delayed significantly. When it's actually going to pick up, you would need a crystal ball to give you that answer. But I think there is a lot of interest in solid oxide electrolyzers. The benefit of solid oxide is very, very efficient. So with heat integration, you can get efficiency up to close to 100%. So especially with applications like downstream ammonia production, downstream steel, refineries, etc., it's a very good fit with solid oxide because of the efficiency. The price of solid oxide today is not competitive. However, the price of solid oxide is also directly driven by volume. And I think our benefit here is that we already have a fuel cell market and we're already scaling for the fuel cell market. So that will help drive down the cost also for the electrolyzer applications when they come along eventually.
Yeah, that's self-explanatory. Economies of scale reduce the unit costs. Let's talk a little bit about first the steel industry. You guys are play a part in that industry already in decarbonizing it. Can you tell us about that, please?
So we have the Sirius project, which is actually integrating an electrolyzer, and that will be the biggest solid oxide electrolyzer of 4.2 megawatt when it comes online. And that is a project together also with our strategic investor Baker Hughes. And the electrolyzer will eventually be installed in a steel factory in Italy. So a couple of pilots going on. Very exciting times for us there.
Plenty of partnerships there. That's fantastic. Staying on the partnerships topic, Casale, you guys signed an MOU with them. What is that all about?
Well, very exciting. Casale is obviously one of the really large ammonia technology suppliers in the world. And what we are trying to do here and achieve here is to us with our solid oxide electrolyzer technology, that's a very good fit with ammonia, and Casale with their ammonia technologies, to benefit from that together and to explore how we can go after projects.
We talked about the fuel cell market. We talked also about fuel cells itself. Can you talk a little bit more on the fuel cell applications?
Yeah, so what we see it right now is we talked about stationary power generation, and that is a market that already exists for fuel cells. Specifically, for instance, in Korea, there is an annual auction for fuel cells. There is a lot of interest in Japan, but perhaps more for smaller systems and backup power. But we also see a lot of interest in China for stationary power generation on natural gas, also on other sources. And then there's obviously the data center market. That is a very big market in the US already today. We see a lot of traction also in other regions. And I think the interest of fuel cell there is it's a secure power supply, but it also has the benefits. If you're running on biogas, for instance, it's also clean power supply. It's also a carbon, basically neutral power supply in that sense, which is important for many customers. Then in Europe, it's more of a mixed bag, but we have a lot of interesting applications. So in Europe, there's a lot of interest around biogas applications that we're working around. And then we're also working with a company, for instance, called What Anywhere, where they are doing EV charging stations on bioethanol, where grid is not available. There's also an emerging application that we also see elsewhere, actually.
Yeah, particularly the advent of the AI industry with servers and data centers, extremely power hungry. We'll see some developments taking place there as well. And hydrogen can definitely play a role. So Elcogen, very active in the upstream as well as the downstream market of the hydrogen industry. Hanna Granö-Fabritius from Elcogen, thank you very much.
Thank you. It's been a pleasure.